let's talk about SUMIF. We'll go through this pretty quickly, but let me know in the comments if it's too quickly and I'll try and slow down for the next video. Super simple way to do this. In column A, we've got sales reps, then we've got the sales team that they're part of, and then we have the January, February, and March, that's Q1 sales for each of the reps. So if we want to do a very quick idea of what SUMIF is, we cover this on Spreadsheet Point as well. Remember that SUMIF asks you for a range and criteria. So we're going to do SUMIF January sales are over 40,000. So the SUMIF range is column C, right? And the next is the criteria, which has to be in quotes. And that means greater than 40,000. And we're going to leave the SUM range empty. That's an optional choice. And that only matters if it differs from that first range. That is the sum of all January sales that were over 40,000. So it only includes reps who made sales that surpassed 40,000. And we can obviously do the quick format as currency. And I removed the decimal places by clicking this button twice. So we can also do COUNTIF, which is usually taught kind of at the same time. If you want to do COUNTIF, same thing. COUNTIF. This range has the criteria of over 40,000. So this is counting the number of sales reps who had sold more than $40,000 in January. There were 7 reps who did it. We can quickly, you know, this is a very small data set, so we can very quickly see if that's accurate. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you'll notice that the sum in the bottom right-hand corner matches what we did up here. So it's a good way to quickly verify. Now let's do a little bit more complex sum if. So again, we're going to be doing the range, the criteria, and then the sum range. And this one, the sum range is going to be different than the criteria range. So the range that we're going to be evaluating is the sales team. The criteria is going to be equals alpha. And then the sum range will be the criteria range from the original one. So team alpha sold $270,000 and $275,000 in January. And we can very quickly do the same calculation for column D for March and April, February and March, if we slightly change this formula. So you'll notice it's just column C that's changing. So we're going to add a dollar sign in front of the cell numbers because everything else is going to stay the same. Basically, we're saying these things, you're not going to change. The only thing that is going to change as we click and drag is going to be the column letter. So click and drag, and it will automatically do, you'll notice that the number here updates, or the cell numbers update to D because we didn't protect them by the dollar sign. So that is Jan, Feb, Mar, and we can do the same thing for Bravo. Just going to change that to Bravo. And then we're going to do the same thing for Charlie. So you'll notice, again, we have the range that we're going to be evaluating. That's B. Then we have the criteria by which we're evaluating. If the cell contains the word Bravo, then we're going to sum things in column C. That is what this means. And again, because we protected it by those dollar signs, we can just click and drag and it'll complete everything else for us. So that is SUMIF with a very simple explanation with sales reps. Let me know what you think in the comments.